Hi all, this is Radhika here again. I hope you all are doing well. So this video is about why do people worry so much? This also relates to narcissism in a way. It's not like a narcissism based video. It's more like a general video. So you might be worrying, or people in your life might be worrying, and you might wonder, why do we worry so much? So worry is actually in Sanskrit or Hindi or Marathi, you'll say it's called as chinta, and chinta is a vritti of the heart chakra. So actually worry comes from the heart. When you worry about someone, it's actually like an amplified version of caring. So because you care, you worry, and when it starts overflowing, it becomes worry. And some people are like compulsive worriers. They have to worry about something. So it's kind of like this. A person who cares for themselves will also care for others. And that's similarly, a person who worries for himself or herself is also going to worry for others. So in normal proportions, worry is not a bad thing, because it basically helps you care for others and have empathy for others as well as yourself, your own body. So it's a good quality to have, unless it becomes like out of proportion, or it basically, as long as it's in balance, it's good. But if it overflows or underflows, that's a problem. So people who worry a lot are often told that you are a worrier, you worry a lot, stop worrying. And at some point, what can happen is such a person can put this quality of worrying in their shadow, especially if they or the people around them are trying to tell them that worrying is a sign of weakness. Of a weaker mind, having a weaker mind, they can put it in their shadow. And what happens is, when they put it in their shadow, they will over time start projecting from their shadow and scapegoating someone. So maybe they start pointing out other people who worry a lot and who are worriers. So people do take pride in being very relaxed or cool, and they attach that to their ego. And a person who is worrying or caring or thinking about other things, they might call such a person as weak, and they might put this quality of worrying in the shadow. So that is sometimes what happens, and such people, they actually worry themselves also, but they have kind of disassociated with that part of themselves, and so they start projecting it out on other people. And another thing that happens is, especially with people who are compulsively worrying, is that they have sometimes in their life been like, they have worried about something, but they have not taken an action, an organic or an authentic action for the thing that they are worrying about. So this worry kind of stays within them. And instead of dealing with it in a good way, what they do is they will start worrying about other people and other people's lives. And this will often be people who are close to them. So like, if you have a parent who worries a lot about you, it is because that parent probably has not taken care of some things that they have, that they worried about at some point, and then they just stayed inactive about it. They didn't do anything about it. And now that worry that they had for themselves has stayed in them, and now they are trying to they get worried about you for those things that they did not take action on. So that's why that's what happens a lot of times when you have you have stayed in a state of inaction for a long time, a part of you knows that you need to take some action against it or for that thing that you want to work on, but that energy basically becomes worry after a while. So that's another thing that happens. Also, news and media, they create a lot of sensationalization. So this kind of produces a state where you feel like there are a lot of bad things happening and you have no control over it. So that also creates like a false worry within you. It's not all false. Of course, a lot of things, bad things are happening. But because of the way it is sensationalized and because somewhere a person feels I am helpless, and because it's also inaction, because they are not doing anything about it. They just keep on feeling and feeling and feeling without taking an action about the feeling. So even because of news and things like that, and because we are not probably contributing in a very positive way to the society, we are not doing our part, we feel this tension of worry build up within us. So that happens. Now, covert narcissists use this a lot, especially like if you have a covert narcissistic parent, you will see this a lot. They will do all sorts of boundary pushing. And in the end, when you call them out on it, they will say, oh, I did it because I was worried about you. So I don't know where the line is there, where they are actually doing it to trouble you, or they know that they are troubling you, but this is an excuse for them. So I don't know that. That kind of depends on a case by case basis on how malignant the person is, or how much they are on the malignant narcissistic side, I would say. It's not the person who's malignant, it's just like they are on that spectrum. Now, overt narcissists are the other side, right? So overt narcissists think that worrying or caring is beneath them, you know. So they feel like that is a sign of weakness, vulnerability. So they will completely put this quality of worrying or having care or empathy for others in the shadow, and they are going to show you like, I don't worry at all, I have everything under control all the time. So that's how overt narcissists relate to worry. So now what to do if you are a worrier? Okay, so first of all, if you have grown up in a narcissistic environment and you did not have like a very nurturing or very grounded childhood, then it is very possible that you are a worrier, and that might be because you have like a generally negative or overly cautious outlook on life, because that was your introduction to life. When you were a child, you saw the world that way, and that's a learned behavior. So the growing years are very important, and a lot of our hard wiring that happens in those years. But that doesn't mean like you can't change it. It just means that you have to put a little more effort to change it. So if you have grown up with narcissistic parent or parents, then this might be the case that your worry is really deep rooted, because you worried a lot since the time you were a child. And so now it has become like a second nature to worry about everything and to be in a more survivalistic kind of outlook. That's one. So there are a lot of ways in which you can actually try to work on this, and I have a video in which I say how to cure or balance your root chakra, so you can take a look at that. Then the second thing that I already mentioned is inaction. So where have you been ignoring yourself or the world around you? So do you really care for your body, or are you not caring for your relationships enough? Do you know you can make a relationship better, but you're not taking the effort to make it better? Is it about career that you are inactive in your career, but internally you want to do good, you want to work hard, you want to climb that ladder, but you are not, basically you are just taking an easy way out of being in your comfort zone. Or are you not relaxing, even though you feel like there is a need for me to slow down and relax? So what is it that is worrying you about yourself? Because that is the thing that is basically going to show you what you need to work on. And once you start working on that in an authentic way, then basically you will, there will be a way of this worry to leave your system, because you're actually taking an action on that worry. So this is like a very masculine way of dealing with that worry, that you actually figure it out what is causing it and you work towards it. Now the other way is like, the third thing is, if you are a, if you are just generally worrying, because in life most of the things are not in our control, then you have to take a more feminine approach to worrying. So you really have to kind of see that what is it that you can do for it, for the thing that you're worrying about. And if you can do something for it, you do whatever you can do for it. And then once you have done your part, you need to just kind of own this fact of life, that not everything is in our control. And what we can do in life is do the best that we can. And after that, we have to let go. And if you have faith, you can pray. If you don't have faith, you don't have to pray. You can move on to the next thing. And you can basically try to detach from the situation and explain to yourself that I have done everything that I can for this particular situation, and worrying is not going to help it any further. And you just have to have some kind of a confidence that because you have put your best intention and effort into it, it should happen. And if it doesn't, you're going to be okay, even if it doesn't happen. So this is a good time to build some confidence in yourself that you are going to survive this. No matter how bad it is, you will come out of it. And once you develop this confidence, which will be very, very deep and very inner confidence, you will automatically stop worrying about things. And you will know that even if the outcome of this thing is not up to your expectation, you are still going to be okay, no matter what the outcome is. So yeah, so that was this video on why people worry so much and what we can do to avoid worrying. Thank you. Hope you like it. Bye.